Hi, I'm Eric. I'm product manager for the EVA volumetric Karl Fischer titrator. Today, I will show you how to do a concentration determination of your titrant and how to perform your first measurement. Let's start with the setup of the resources that are needed for the concentration determination. The polarized sensor and the burette with the assigned titrant are automatically identified and created by the system upon connection. However, the KF cell and the concentration standard are not automatically set up and need to be manually configured to be used in the titration method later on. To create the KF standard, open the main menu, choose Setup, Chemicals, Standard and click on New Standard. In this example, we define the standard value in milligram per gram, so let's choose this option. Then we adjust the standard concentration to the actual value written in the standard certificate and click on Create to finish the standard setup. The KF cell does not need to be created. There already exists a default KF cell under setup hardware. Nevertheless, we need to check if it's configured correctly. Means to check if the physically installed KF cell matches the one configured in the setup. In this example, we use the large KF peaker to measure. The resource entry is therefore correct. It's good practice to also check the entries of the automatically identified resources. Check if the nominal concentration of the titrant is correct and if the type and name of the connected sensor match the physically connected one. The connection fields show to which socket of the boards the resource is connected to and indicates that the communication is working correctly. After finishing the resource setup, we need to fill our burette with KF titrant. Under Operation, Action, Burette, you will find the option to rinse the burette. Choose 3 cycles and stop it manually when the titrant flows out of the tube into the cell. Make sure that there are no air bubbles in the burette or the tubes. If there are, fasten the tubes more tightly and rinse the bubbles out. Let's now fill the KF cell using the operation solvent exchange. Stop the filling process manually as soon as the solvent level reaches the pins of the polarized sensor. We are now ready to create the method for the titrant concentration determination. Choose a template for a standard defined in milligram per gram. Give it the name or ID and save it. In our example, we do not need to configure the method any further. For more information on method configuration and on all method parameters, please consult the reference manual. It's good practice to adjust the concentration of the titrant daily. Thus, we want to give the operator direct access to this important method via a shortcut. In the method under Create Task, there is an option to create a shortcut for the home screen. We start with the actual concentration determination. Enter the number of certified standards that you want to measure and start the task via the shortcut. After the cell is conditioned and the start button turns green, the system is ready to receive samples. The concentration determination adjusts the nominal concentration to the actual one and corrects all the systematic errors of the measuring system. Ultimately, the actual concentration of titrant determines the accuracy of the sample measurement that we do afterwards. Thus, it is very, very important to do it frequently and accurately. I suggest you to do it at least once per measuring day. To prepare the certified water standard for the concentration determination, open the ampulla and pull approximately 0.5 ml of the standard into the syringe. Wet the inside and rinse it out to remove the residual water. Then fill the whole syringe with the standard. Make sure to remove all the air from the syringe. Tear the full syringe on a suitable laboratory balance. Click on Start Standard and inject a sample with an absolute amount of water of around 10 mg. The sample has a water content of 10 mg per gram, thus I inject here 1 gram of sample. During injection, watch the tip of the needle and make sure that every single drop reaches the solvent. After the injection of the standard, weigh back the syringe on the teared balance and enter the absolute weight on the titrator screen. On this system, the balance is connected via USB to the titrator for automatic weight transfer. So, the weight must only be confirmed, but not to be entered. Measure two more standards the same way. After all three standards are measured, the mean of the three measurements is saved as actual concentration of the titrant resource. The next time you use this titrant resource for a titration, the corrected actual concentration is used for calculating the result. Having the actual concentration of the titrant determined, we are now ready to accurately measure the water content of a real sample. In our example, I want to know the water content of industrial alcohol, a very easy sample. Similar as before, we create a method and shortcut. However, this time we are using a template of type KF volumetric. Start the task to measure the industrial alcohol sample from the shortcut, and as soon as the cell is conditioned and ready, add the sample from the prepared syringe. Enter the weight and wait for the sample to be finished to go on with the next one. The mean and all the statistics of the result set can be found under results. The water content of our industrial ethanol is measured to be 1.75%, which is quite feasible.
And that's how easy and fast we can obtain reliable results with our EVA Karl Fischer titrator. For more information, please visit our website.